How do I change the email address of my Microsoft account? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I'm here to admit to you that I was wrong. I was wrong about what it means to have a Microsoft account. For the longest time, I was under the impression that your email address was a Microsoft account and that a different email address always implied a different Microsoft account. As it turns out, that's not true. Like I said, I was wrong. You can actually change the email address associated with your Microsoft account. Let me show you how to do that because it is not obvious. So we're over here in Windows 10. I've got outlook.com up, just because I consider that probably the most likely place that folks are spending their time. What we'll do is we'll click on the icon in the upper right. That's a couple of letters in my case, since I haven't set a profile picture or your profile picture. We'll click on that and we'll click on My Microsoft Account. Now, normally when we're talking about email addresses and passwords and security and all that kind of stuff, we would scroll down or click on the security tab. That's not what we want to do. In this case, we want to go to your info. There's a bunch of information, but if we scroll down, you'll see that there is an email address, and that is the email address of this Microsoft account. Great. We'll click on Sign in preferences. Of course, it wants my password again, just to confirm that I'm not playing a game here. Now, this is an important concept, I guess, that I understood existed, but I didn't know it applied to this. You can have aliases for your Microsoft account. In other words, you can have multiple email addresses that all send their email into your single email account. As it turns out, you can also set up aliases to be used as alternate ways to sign in. What we do is we add email. We're not going to create a new email address. We're going to add an existing email address as a Microsoft account address. The one I'm going to use is askleotest@gmail.com. Yes, it doesn't have to be a Microsoft account. So we have askleotest@gmail.com. You'll see that it sent an email to the Gmail account asking me to confirm that obviously I have access to this account, that it is indeed my account. So we'll click on, if you added this email address as an alias, use this link to verify. Click on that. And now we're here. We've got our two different email addresses associated with this account. Now, to be clear, since I'm using a non-Microsoft email address, email sent to that address will still go to Gmail. It will not come to Outlook.com. If you had used a Microsoft email account or created a new alias, then I believe email routing would be affected. But in this case, that's not the case. However, we can now do something interesting. We can now make this primary. This will be the alias that appears on Microsoft devices, and you can also sign in with any of your other aliases. Man, I don't want information and tips. Yes. Now, at this point, we have changed the primary alias for this account. Having done this, there's a couple of important things to note. One is that when you establish an alias like this, and you can have several of them if you like, you can use any of them to sign into your Microsoft account. It's the same password, but it's a different email address. So, for example, for this Microsoft account, I can sign in using either the email address askleotest@gmail.com or the email address askleofree@outlook.com. Since I have now changed the primary to be askleotest@gmail.com, I theoretically can remove the original email address. Great warning, because if you remove this, you will not be able to use it to send or receive email in Outlook.com. That email address will no longer work. My recommendation is that you not remove this email address, this email alias, so that for those things for which you are still getting email on that address, you will continue to still get email on that address. At a minimum, I would recommend strongly that you delay, probably for many months, removing this email alias, if that is in fact your long-term intent. But once we've done this, like I said, we can now use either of these email addresses to sign in. In fact, let me prove that to you. I'm going to close my extra windows here and sign out. So I am now signed out. In fact, you can see there's no indication of who I am at this point. I'm going to, of course, go to Outlook.com, which will ask me to sign in. It's pre-populating with what I used before, which will still work. However, what I'm going to do instead now is say askleotest@gmail.com. Next. And now the trick here, and I'm doing this using my password manager that you can't see, so that I can copy in the correct password. Because like I said, the email address changed, but the password did not. So I'm going to paste in the correct password and click on sign in. And it's just asking me if I want to stay signed in. Sure, why not? So I have signed in to this account using a different email address. This account will receive email sent to the askleofree@outlook.com email address. askleotest@gmail.com will continue to go to Gmail. But I can use either email address to sign in to my Microsoft account. I hope that helps. I realize that it's a confusing concept. If you're still confused, by all means, leave a comment, let me know what I've missed, and we'll try and clarify that for you. But like I said, I was wrong. You can actually have multiple email addresses associated with your Microsoft account. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/169651. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.